So today we're gonna speak about the PCV valve and why I choose to block it, even if there are already many other options. But before, I want to talk to you about a little bit how this system works. So, supposing that you know how an engine works, I have to just remind you that the pressure from the explosion in the open space at the top of the cylinder, which is also called the combustion chamber, drives the piston in the cylinder downward, where it causes the crankshaft to rotate. Meanwhile, the rising piston pushes the air and gas left, which are left over from the explosion, back out of the cylinder through an exhaust valve. That is where crankcase ventilation comes in. So a certain amount of that mixture of air and gasoline is pulled down by the piston and slips through the piston rings back into the crankcase. So this escaping gas is called usually blow-by gases, and you cannot do anything in order to avoid it. And it's also not good because the unburned gasoline in it can produce problems in the crankcase. But before 1960, when the PCV system was invented, these gases were left outside freely. But after 1960, they became more worried about environment, so they invented the PCV, the positive crankcase ventilation, which involves recycling of these gases through a valve called the PCV valve into the intake manifold, where they are pumped back into the cylinders for another shot at the combustion. So it isn't always desirable to have these gases in the cylinders because they tend to mostly to be air, and they can make the gas-air mixtures in the cylinders a little too lean, that is too low on gasoline, so it's not an effective combustion. So the blow-by gases should only be recycled when the car is traveling at slow speeds or is idling. Fortunately, when the engine is idling, the air pressure in the intake manifold is lower than the air pressure in the crankcase. And it's this lower pressure, which is very low, it's close to vacuum, that sucks the blow-by gases to the PCV valve back into the intake. But when the engine is not idling, so the engine speeds up, the air pressure in the intake manifold increases and the suction slows down, reducing the amount of blow-by gas recycled to the cylinders. So this is good because the blow-by gases are needed when the engine speeds up. In fact, when the car is up to speed, the pressure in the intake manifold can actually become higher than the pressure in the crankcase, potentially forcing the blow-by gases back into the crankcase. So since the whole point of positive crankcase ventilation is to keep these gases out of the crankcase, the PCV valve is designed to close off when this happens and block the backflow of gases. So usually in MK5 GTIs and also others, the PCV delete is quite good because it's stopping the intake valves getting covered in crap, or at least slows down massively because, you know, these valves will get covered in a lot of stuff because the gasoline is not circulating around the valves. That's why there will be like a black non-humid or humid carbon build up there. So the stage one, how it's called, PCV delete, is just replacing this OEM PCV valve with another plate, which actually is looking like this. It has the same O-ring. So what is the advantage of actually removing the OEM PCV valve and installing a PCV delete kit? Well, the PCV delete actually keeps the recycled vapor pad open all the time rather than just when there is a boost pressure. So when there is a vacuum in the intake manifold, the intake is able to suck air from the intake before the turbo because it doesn't close the pad. Note that the engine is using the turbo when vacuum is present. Basically, when you do a stage one PCV delete, you keep the pad open and vapors always have to pass through the turbo weather under boost or vacuum, and all of it ends up passing the intake valves eventually. So with the OEM PCV, the vapors take the long way under boost and then go directly in the intake manifold under the vacuum. Or some of the people are doing a complete delete. It's like you remove this hole and also this hole, but that means that all the gases will go outside in the atmosphere, and that's not indicated to do. So by removing the PCV valve and doing the PCV delete kit, actually it removes the PCV and links the two internal ports together, which emulates what happens inside the stock PCV when the engine is on boost, but without any fragile components to break or split. This completely isolates the inlet manifold from the cam cover. And instead of using a PCV delete kit, you can use an oil catch can system, which is way better, a little bit more expensive, but it's way better. Why? Because it completely is replacing this, so it prevents crankcase oil deposit in intake manifolds and on intake valves. It also reduces carbon buildup on valves and also ensures a proper crankcase ventilation. So you can imagine that an oil catch can is actually like a PCV valve, but instead of having the two hoses directly to the engine, the two hoses exist, but at the end of each hose there will be an oil catch can which will take the air and oil here. It will filter them with a carbon active filter and then take it back to the other hose into the system. But the one disadvantage is that during the winter you can have some condensed water from humidity in the oil catch can or on the hoses, so it's better to not use it during winter, or clean the oil catch can more regularly, for example at every 1 or 2 weeks. So as a conclusion, you can have three choices: either you replace the OEM PCV valve completely, either you buy the PCV delete kit so you get rid of this thing and you'll have only this plate and this one, and these ones will be blocked, and the third solution, which is quite recommended from most of the people, is buying an oil catch can. That means it looks like a PCV delete kit, but instead of blocking one way, actually you will have two hoses and one oil catch can at the end, where you will have to clean it regularly, and this will also help you maintaining the function of the engine like us with an OEM PCV valve, but it will filter the air and oil in excess. So it's up to you. Three choices.